If you guys are looking for super cheap, fast, and reliable Madden 21 coins, look no further than my sponsor, MuttReserve.com. Coins are currently discounted, guys. They got 24/7 support. They're super awesome to work with. Head on over, use code Poodle for an additional 15% off your order. What's on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team Leader, guys. And today, I'm going to be going over a few things here. So first, my week in league update. So pretty much, I'm going to go through this, show you guys my week in league lineup that I went in with, what I played with, have made no changes since we started this. So week in league lineup. Week in league update as far as my record, my games, kind of how things have been going for me specifically, for all you guys probably wondering. And then also going to go through my potential rewards and what I do kind of hope to get now. For all you guys who haven't played week in league before, I feel like this could be useful because I'm going to go over kind of what rewards you really want to hit for, like at bare minimum, how the monthlies go, kind of how I've been doing in week in league, my personal overall view of it, and just kind of how I've been rocking. So we're going to start with the lineup, of course, go through that, show you guys what I've been working with for week in league. Now, personally, I don't have the best lineup. I don't even have a great lineup, in my opinion. I think my lineup is subpar at best. And now, I know to most that might not seem likely, but compared to some of the teams that I go up against and a few other YouTubers, trust me, my team is not the greatest at all. But it gets the job done, which is going to show you that it doesn't take a God Squad to compete in Weekend League. All it takes is a few things and the right mindset with your team. So like I've been telling you guys, don't always just buy. And I've learned this. I finally matured enough to realize this. Don't just buy players to make your overall look good. It doesn't win for you on Sundays, right? So I used to be the guy that, like, I didn't use a third receiver. I never used my third wide receiver, almost ever. And I would buy 99 overall with third wide receiver. I don't care how many coins it costs. I want my overall to look good. I want my team to look good. But I know how I play. I know I play very simplistic. I get the run game going. I make easy reads. And I just keep it going down the field until it works. So all I need is a fast receiver to burn people. A bigger receiver to make some good catches, a third slot for when they're tired, and then just a decent quarterback. He's not great. He's not that crazy accurate, but he gets the job done. And then a tight end that's just fast. Jonnu Smith has been, guys, if you want to know, Jonnu Smith is a monster, low-key. But anyways, before we get into the video, guys, go down below, hit that subscribe button, turn that on to our boys, come join the family. Make sure to use code Poodle at MuttReserve.com if you guys do need coins to pick up some players for your weekend league squad. Down below in the description, you guys already know the deal. And comment down below, let me know what overall you guys have been rocking with. The line's great. The line's iffy. Like, it's great in some parts, like Larry Allen and Trent Williams, but I definitely noticed the issue I have with Lane Johnson. Probably should have got someone better for that, but I was low on coins. And this is the defense. Now, my defense has been playing great, guys. Now, if I could recommend one thing, and just one thing you guys need for your weekend league lineup, it's going to be Isaiah Simmons. This has been the greatest card I think I've ever started with to start the year. Isaiah Simmons is my user. I put him in the box. That's why, guys, example, why is my right outside linebacker so bad? Why is my left outside linebacker so bad? Why are my middle linebacker so bad? Because, yes, if I got a right outside and I got a left outside, I got everything, it would make my team look so much better. But I actually don't use outside linebackers. Now, will I eventually? Yes. Will I get a Khalil Mack and then put him on the edge? Maybe. But right now, the way I play defense, because I don't have the players I currently have, I play in a big nickel scheme, I'd only use one middle linebacker. I only use one linebacker in general. And then I put Isaiah Simmons as one of my other linebackers. And then Tyron Matthews in the box as a sub corner, like sub nickel corner. And that's just how I rock with that. And then Yannick Ngakoue is on the edge. I put Aaron Donald on the defensive tackle. I just move things around like that. So in that sense, it doesn't look pretty, but trust me, it gets the job done. And that's pretty much it for that. I mean, you guys need so much more. I use the Patriots playbook for all you guys probably ask. You know, I know I'm going to get that question. I use Patriots playbook and then Giants defensive playbook. And the Cowboys Stadium for a gameplay I did. And honestly, I like the dome. Although it says open, I like the feel of the whole dome. Now, let's get into my record, kind of how things are going with that. What I kind of expect to land here. Now, it is Sunday, guys. So today's my final day. Although, don't forget, you can pretty much play on Monday. You just have to play really early in the morning. So just remember, if you're ever like 3 wins left and you're super tired, just set an alarm for like 6, 7 a.m. and you have until 10 a.m. to play. Just make sure you get that last game done before 10 a.m. hits, because it will kick you out. Or it just won't count, I'm pretty sure. But anyway, so I have 11 wins with 10 games remaining. That's not great. But again, I had a few rough games. Like I had some games where I should have won, and I just really, it was me. I'm the kind of person that can't play. The thing is, like, I could play the first game, kill someone, destroy. Second game, pretty good. But like the third, fourth game, I'm just screwing around. I'm on my phone. I don't have the attention span to stay that focused. Well, not that I can't stay focused. I can't put 100% effort into that game as much as I did the first two games. But I still think it's pretty good for my squad. Like, you know, not without a God Squad, going up against God Squads, 11-10 is not horrible. It does put me on pace for 21 wins, which I will not get 21 wins, guys, because it gets significantly harder with the way the algorithm and the whole matchmaking, the whole way this works. It just keeps getting harder. So I project, guys, 16 wins. I think that's fair. So the bare minimum, I think 15-16 wins. which would put me at about 50% left. I'd have to win 50% of the rest of my games, which is pretty likely because I usually don't lose back-to-back games. I usually at least go one. If at worst, I go 1-1 and 1-1 and 1-1 back-to-back-to-back like that. But if I could even just win 70% of my games, I could just clock out at around 17-18. I'd be more than happy. Again, now, why is this? Because I am going for this one right here. I do wish... Oh, bare minimum, I want MVP. Bare minimum, I think MVP is the one you really want. Now, if you're just competing just to get some extra rewards, you know, star and all-star is fine. But MVP for me is what I need for monthlies, and I'll explain that in a second. Because the way monthlies works is pretty much it adds up all every week of all your wins. And then at the end of the month, if you have a certain threshold of wins, which I'll show you guys right here, you get better rewards. So that's kind of important, guys, in terms of... your big rewards. So at the end of the, and those rewards are the best ones. Like you play weekly for some rewards, but the monthly rewards are the bangers. Those are the ones you really want. So let's go here. So okay, so we go to monthly details. So right here is what's important. So top 100 is where I'm not going to get. So legend, which I believe legend was, let's see, where do I check this? I don't remember how to check this per se, but oh, right here, monthly. So to place legend, you need 60 wins. So for 60 wins, that would be 15 wins a week, which really isn't that bad. Now, MVP would be around like 13, 14 wins a week, depending on the week, maybe 16 one week, 12 one week, but that's not bad either. So I feel like these are easily obtainable, each 15 wins a week minimum. So if I can even play 17 or 18, that'd be way better because then I can put myself ahead it for a bad week. But here you go. So if I get legend, guys, I'll get an 85 plus fantasy pack, 1 out of 5, which is an insane pack, guys. That pretty much guarantee, I mean, almost always, like not almost always, but most of the time people pull at least one full legend out of that pack. I can pull full legends, I can pull LTDs. That's the banger pack. Obviously, the Fire Fantasy is even better, but we all know I won't be getting top 100 for the month. That's damn near impossible for myself, considering I already am not going to place in the top 100. So, I have placed top 100 before, but for the week, I've never placed monthly. That's very hard. You have to be consistently great, and that's not, well, consistently amazing, I should say. But Legends perfect, guys, or even MVP. MVP is good, too, for all you guys. That's not that hard, 13 wins a week, you know. Give or take, it's going to be 52, so you're going to need like 13, 14 alternate. So the fantasy pack 81 pluses, 1 out of 3, really isn't that bad. You get 2 of them, it's not horrible, it really isn't. I mean, yes, you might get all 81s, but you also get the 15 gold players and some training for just playing the game. It's really not that bad of a value, though. I think Legend is definitely better, because this one, MVP could just literally be a bunch of 81s, 82s, 83s, and it's like, 85s are guaranteed to be some bangers, in my opinion. And that pack usually just does good. And 2,400 training right now is a lot of training. So I could definitely use that. And then we got our weekly, the weekly stuff, which isn't great. I mean, if I get, let's see, legend, I get 50,000 coins, 3 series trophies, and then you get all-star tier packs plus 2 touchdown packs. So you guys get the point. You can just sell the touchdown packs, take the quick sell, get some coins. You end up getting like 150K off this, which is honestly really useful considering the state of the game right now and how important coins are. But yeah. That's pretty much it for my lineup update and my weekend league and pretty much what I'm going over, guys. I think I'll get, I'm hoping for, my goal is 17 wins. If I can get 17 wins, that'd be great. Again, that could be tough. Games get harder. Like I said, the first 5 games are super easy. Like I went 6-0. Then the second 5 games are a bit harder. And then once you hit like 10 games and 10 wins, it starts to get harder as you ramp up opponents. Also, guys, quick advice. It depends on the day you play too. Remember, some players play on certain days. So like some of the competitive players that play on multiple games, they might start day one. Like a joke or one of those guys, they might start day one or day two. So sometimes playing your games all on a Sunday might be easier. But then again, there's other people who have that same mindset. Because if you play on Sunday, all the best players might already have played. Best way to check that is go to leaderboards and just kind of see the top 100. So the top 100, there's 25-0s, 25-0s, 25-0, 24-0. If you guys just see this right here, you know that a lot of the best players have played already. The best way to check it too is scroll all the way down. If you see some stragglers in here, like usually... So this is the first week, though, so it might be a little bit different, but usually 18 wins won't cut it, okay? So 19 wins probably won't cut it either. So it'll probably end up capping around 19-20, more than likely, but 19 usually on a better month may not even cut it. So that's about it, guys. I just say recommend checking the days you play, make sure everyone's played already, because when you check this thing and they're all like 13 wins, 12 wins, you know all the best players are not even done yet, so definitely want to be careful there. But it, guys, enjoy the rest of your day. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did like the style of video, I will be doing this more for you guys weekly, but let me know. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to subscribe, hit that noti bell. Comment down below, let me know what you guys think. Smash the like button, and make sure you use code Poodle on Mutt Reserve if you want to build the God Squad to play on Weekend League, or just build a decent squad like myself and go ahead and compete. But guys, I'm out. Thanks for watching. Peace.